Tonight, we honor the life of a legend, the legendary Stu Hart. Stu blazed his way into the early years of professional wrestling, becoming an international star. However, Stu settled down in Calgary, Alberta, Canada, where he and his late wife, Helen, reared 12 children, all of whom, in one way or another, became involved with professional wrestling. Through the years, Stu earned enormous respect from his colleagues, who will always be grateful for his unparalleled contributions to our business. Tonight, the WWE family's thoughts and prayers are with the Hart family. The legacy of Stu Hart lives on.
On a sadder note, that we begin our show tonight. Stu Hart, the father of Brett and the late Owen Hart, passed away a couple of weeks ago from complications due to his diabetes and pneumonia. He was 88 years old. Stu lived a full life and is remembered in wrestling circles for his contributions to this business. Wrestling was a family affair for the Harts, and two of Stu's children, Brett and Owen, became premier superstars of the World Wrestling Federation in their day. While Stu became famous because of his offspring, his contributions to wrestling extend much farther. He trained several current WWE superstars, including Chris Jericho, Lance Storm, and Chris Benoit. And tonight, those superstars, along with others who knew him well, sat down and talked about the man, Stu Hart.
I think what Stu Hart meant to the wrestling industry is almost inexplainable. You can't put it in words.
In my opinion, Stu Hart was unquestionably a true icon in the industry.
Stu Hart is obviously a legendary character in the business, and there's a lot of legends in wrestling, but I think Stu kind of stands above almost all of them. As a performer in the ring, Stu was a great wrestler, a great, as we call in the business, a shooter. He knew a lot of submission holds. I think when Stu passed away, a lot of holds passed away that I don't think a lot of people know anymore.
He came up in a day where everything was brutal strength, wrestling holds, wrestling knowledge, and he was very respected.
Stu Hart was a pioneer in the wrestling profession, and he'll be remembered as one of the greatest trainers of all time.
Stu was legendary for his training down in the dungeon.
When you think of all the names that, you know, started out in Stampede Wrestling or passed through there along the way to attaining great fame within the industry, the opportunities that Stu Hart gave to all those individuals speaks for itself.
Through Stampede Wrestling, I think he accelerated the evolution of the business. I think Stampede Wrestling had a tight connection with New Japan Pro Wrestling, and he brought a lot of athletes from Japan to Calgary, and by that Japanese style,
which meant it was quicker, less on the crazy cartoon gimmicks, more emphasis on wrestling, which is basically, I think, was the precursor for the style that we wrestle today.
Describe Stu Hart to someone who had never met him. You know, there's a lot of avenues we could take here. We could talk about how he used to talk.
Everybody in wrestling knows who Luthez is, but I bet you nobody knows what Luthez sounded like. In this business, everybody has a rendition of Stu's voice.
Well, everybody knows that he kind of really talked slow and gruff. You little mugger, you. Let me here a minute. Let me see. Oh, you're a big bastard. Get over here, you little bastard.
I would never let him show me a hold, because if he showed me a hold, he would probably hurt me.
If you allowed Stu to put you in one of his holds, you would pay the price. Now, in a street fight, you would, if a guy said, here, give me your arm, you would never go, okay, here, take the arm. But because it was Stu, you know, from a respect standpoint, you go, okay, here's my arm, Stu, what's a 75-year-old man going to do? And then about 3 seconds later, stop it. And he would never move, and he would always go, you know,
if you then grab the pinky and pull it back, it makes you scream even harder. And it's like, And then if you take the thumb and make it touch the pinky and tie it in a bow,
Stu was a sick old bastard. he would never break his face. He would always keep a straight face and just tell you how many more ways he could make you scream in complete agony. think Stu will most be remembered for his contributions as a promoter, as a performer, as a trainer, and just as a character. Everybody in this business knows the Stu Hart story. Everybody's heard about his cats. Everybody's heard the rumors of, you know, Stu cooking Sunday breakfast and taking the eggs and dolloping out and then picking up some cat poop and throwing the garbage and taking the eggs and dolloping out. Somebody. Rumor or truth, does it really matter?
You know, you could go on about how good of a person he was. I mean, when I started out, I was 17 years old at the Hart House, didn't know a thing about pro wrestling, and, you know, he believed in me.
Stu was a great teacher, and there was so much to learn from just listening to his stories and watching the way that Stu handled himself.
Just after he died, I read an article in the Calgary Sun talking about, Brett actually wrote it, saying how he used to talk about Stu and how both of them didn't watch wrestling a lot, but when they did, they were fans of Chris Benoit and Chris Jericho. And to know that Stu Hart appreciated what I did and enjoyed my work, to me, is kind of like the ultimate pat on the back.
He's just this living entity that'll live on even in death. It's Stu. You can't even explain it.